Tutorial 10, Creating and Managing Bays. In this tutorial, you will learn how to make a simple fixture and save it for future use. Start a new project with the new button, then click on the Create Bay task. In Planogram Builder, bays are composed of various parametric elements, such as back panels, shelves, and side panels. The Create Bay task is where you define new bays and their parameters. Enter the desired width of the bay. Note how the preview on the right updates to reflect the new value. Specify the overall height of the bay. As an alternative, you can enter the spacing between each shelf. Set the desired number of shelves, not counting the base shelf nor the top cover if any. Choose a color for your bay structure. Enter the width, depth, height, and color of the shelves. The shelf front margin determines how far the products will be placed from the front edge of the shelves. This is useful if you must reserve some front space for a shelf ledge or for tester out-of-box products, for example. Put a check next to base and define its dimensions. This is your bottommost shelf, often larger than the other shelves. Make sure back panel is also checked and define its parameters. Check accept items to allow pegged products on this back panel. Back panel top margin determines the amount of vertical space from the utmost shelf to the top of the back panel. Back panel L plus RR margins define the left and right offset compared to the shelf's width. Hook length lets you set how long the hooks will be for pegged products attached to this panel. Back panel depth is its thickness. Note that the height of the base, back panel, and top cover may affect the overall height of the bay. So, after changing the height of these elements, check and adjust it if necessary. For this bay, you won't add a top cover or side panels, since this is a non-enclosed bay. Now that the basic parameters are set, click on the Add button on the toolbar to place the bay in the current planogram. At this stage, your project contains just the empty bay. If you wish to reuse this bay for other planograms, it is a good idea to save it as a project. We suggest using a descriptive name so you can easily find the bay in the future. Then, to use the saved bay in any planogram, proceed as follows. Create a new project or open an existing one. For example, open the sample planogram project. To use the saved bay in this planogram, click on Open, select the desired bay project and click on Add. The bay is added to your current planogram project. Repeat the process to add more copies of the bay. If you are going to use a specific bay very often, you can also make it a template. Click on Manage, select the empty bay project, check the template checkbox, and click Update to apply this change, then close the Manage panel. To use the bay in the current planogram, click on the Templates task, then simply drag the bay thumbnail into the planogram viewing area. You will learn how to create more complex fixtures and edit existing ones in our next tutorial.